Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we completed the cargo from the ship contract. In this episode, I'd like to complete the threatening accident and unfortunate event tasks here in Smithville Dam. These are similar to the other lost cargo missions and will require us to recover oil barrels in various locations around the map. I've left these as some of the last tasks to complete in Michigan as they will require us to reconfigure some of the add-ons we're using on our vehicles. First, I'll take the Fleet Star with the ramped flatbed and drop off the trailer near the task start point. Next, we'll need to take the Fleet Star back to the garage. After topping up with fuel, I'll also pick up the sideboard trailer we left earlier and drop it off at the garage. I'll swap from the sideboard bed to a low saddle, then run the Fleet Star back to where we parked the ramped flatbed. Next, I'll bring down the Chevy so we can refuel the trucks during these tasks. We'll need to install the sideboard bed back on the white Western Star, so the next job is to take it back to the garage. I'll leave the sideboard semi-trailer parked here as we may have a use for it later, for contracts or for the logging missions. With the sideboard bed reinstalled, we can head back past the farm and pick up the first barrels. The first load of barrels is in the river, on the path we took when we towed the White Western Star back to the garage for the fixer-upper task. The truck will tend to sink in the mud here when stationary, but if it does get stuck, there are some fallen trees which can be used as winch points. We'll need to make our way along the bank of the river and then cross the path we've taken with the Chevy as the second load of barrels is on the other side of the river near the rocky section. Getting back up the hill shouldn't be too difficult if you pick a good line through the rocks. If the truck gets unbalanced or looks like it may tip, then using the trees as a winch point may help. Now we can offload the first two loads of oil barrels onto the rammed flatbed. I'm going to take the same path back around the river to pick up the next two loads of barrels. It is possible to take the path near where we picked up the lock diff upgrade for the Chevy, or go all the way around to where we dropped off the cement for the lost bags task earlier, and if you're delivering directly back to the fuel station, this may be a better option. The sand here is treacherous. It's best to stay close to but not run over the fallen trees just in case you need to winch out, and only go as close to the barrels as is necessary. We'll need to continue along the bank, as the last load of barrels is on a small rocky section in the middle of the river. For a moment there, I was actually concerned the barrels were going to get taken by the current of the river and almost forgot about using the anchors of the crane. Thank you. With the last load of barrels on board, we can head back again and offload them onto the Fleet Star's ramped flatbed. We can now use the Fleet Star to deliver the barrels to the fuel station. Thank you. With that task complete, I'll switch back to the Chevy and pick up the unfortunate event task. We'll need to use the White Western Star again for this one. It's similar to the previous task, but we'll need to deliver the barrels to the warehouse. There is one load of barrels close to the warehouse, but I'll pick those up last on the way back. The fastest way to get to the other two loads of barrels is to again find a path along the bank of the river. Stay close to the trees here as the ground seems a bit more solid and you have a winch point in case the vehicle gets stuck. As in the sandy section earlier, I think it's best to only get as close to the barrels as is necessary to reach them with the crane. Again, make sure to stay in range of the trees while loading these barrels, as the truck will sink in the mud. We can now head back and pick up the last load of barrels. The drop-off zone is just over the small rise, so carrying the extra barrels like this doesn't pose too much risk, but it's also not far to pick them up on a separate trip either. We now just have the Lost Trailer task to complete in Michigan, then we can start making preparations for moving over to Alaska. But I'll save that for the next episode. Thanks for watching.